स्टूडेंट्स, थर्ड बीएससी एमपीसी एंड एमपीसीएस सिक्स्थ सेमेस्टर। इन दिस क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट ऑपरेशनल एम्पलीफायर्स। सो दिस इज the first topic in second unit, so what is meant by an operational amplifier? So operational amplifier is that is also called as op amp, is a linear device that can give ideal DC amplification. This amplifier fundamentally voltage amplifying device which is used with external feedback component like resistor or capacitor. So in reality, operational amplifiers do not attain perfection. The input impedance level of mega ohms and more, and very low output impedance levels. So those are the characteristics of operational amplifiers. So these characteristics we will discuss at the end of this session. The simple circuit diagram for operational amplifier is this. So this is an operational amplifier structure. So in this structure you can observe different different points, so which is inverting and this is non-inverting inputs. So this operational amplifier contains two input signals, so one output signal or output terminal, two input terminals and one output terminal. So an operational amplifier is three terminal device with one terminal is called as inverting terminal and other one is non inverting terminal and third one is output. So as you can see this diagram, so there are three terminals for input and output and two power supplies. Power supplies plus and minus. So before we understand the operation of an operational amplifier, we must learn about the operational amplifier characteristics of an op amp. So first characteristic is open loop voltage gain. Open loop voltage gain. So second one is input impedance. Output impedance, bandwidth, offset voltage and common mode rejection ratio. So first open loop voltage gain. So this open loop voltage gain open loop voltage gain without any feedback for an ideal operational amplifier is infinity. Please wait. So first characteristic is open loop voltage gain open loop voltage gain this open loop voltage gain without any feedback for an ideal operational amplifier is infinity but typical values of open loop voltage gain for an ideal operational amplifier ranges from 20,000 2 lakhs. So let the input voltage V is VIN. A be the input voltage. And VIN, sorry. And A be the open loop voltage gain then the output voltage is V out is equal to A into V in. Therefore A is equal to voltage gain is equal to V output by V input. So the value of typically is then the range specified above, but for an ideal operational amplifier is infinity. Okay, right. Second characteristic is input impedance. Denoted by Z input. So here the input impedance is defined as the voltage, input voltage by the input current. Input is equal to input voltage by input current. So the input impedance for an ideal operational amplifier is also infinity. So because the input impedance, input current is zero, then zero by anything is, sorry, anything by zero is equal to infinity. That is, there is no current flowing in the input circuit. However, an ideal operational amplifier has certain current flowing in the input circuit of the magnitude of few pico amperes, few milli amperes. So third characteristic is output impedance, so denoted by Z out. The output impedance is defined as, output impedance is defined as output voltage by output current. So in case of operational amplifier, the output impedance of an ideal operational amplifier is zero, because the maximum input I. So here the real operational amplifier has an output impedance of nearly 10 to 20 kilo ohms. So ideal operational amplifier behaves like a perfect voltage source, so delivering current without any internal losses. So the internal resistance reduces the voltage available to the load. So this is output impedance. Output impedance. So once again I repeat you. So input impedance of operational amplifier is infinity. So because input impedance is defined as the input voltage, the ratio between the input voltage to the input current. The input impedance of an ideal operational amplifier is infinity. So that there is no current flowing in the input circuit. So however, an ideal operational amplifier has certain current flowing in the input circuit of the magnitude of few pico amperes to a few milli amperes. So next one is output impedance. So output impedance is defined as output, Z output is equal to output voltage, the ratio between the output voltage to input, sorry, output current. So this value becomes zero. So output impedance of the operational amplifier is zero. So a real operational amplifier have certain value 10 to 20 kilo ohms. So an ideal operational amplifier behaves like a perfect voltage source. So which delivers current without any internal losses. The internal resistance reduces the voltage available to the load. So this is the input impedance and output impedance of operational amplifiers. So next topic is next characteristic. The third characteristic is bandwidth. So next characteristic is bandwidth. bandwidth of an operational amplifier. So ideal operational amplifier bandwidth is infinity, because the bandwidth that is it can amplify any signal from DC to highest AC frequency, so without any losses. So therefore an ideal operational amplifier is said to be at infinite frequency response. In real operational amplifiers, the bandwidth is generally some limiting value. The limiting value depends on the gain bandwidth. The real value depends on the gain bandwidth. So that is gain bandwidth product. So the GB is defined as the gain bandwidth is defined as the frequency where the amplifier gain becomes unity. So GB, where gain bandwidth is defined as the frequency where the amplifier gain becomes unity. So that is bandwidth characteristic. So next characteristic is offset voltage, denoted by VIO. Here the offset voltage of an ideal operational amplifier is zero. So which means that the output voltage will be zero. So if the difference between inverting and non-inverting terminals will be zero. Okay, ఇక్కడ ఆఫ్సెట్ వోల్టేజ్ ఎంత ఉంటుంది ఐడియల్ ఆపరేషనల్ యాంప్లిఫైయర్కి జీరో ఉంటుంది. సో ఎందుకు జీరో ఉంటుంది అంటే, సో ద ఇన్వర్టింగ్ అండ్ నాన్ ఇన్వర్టింగ్ టెర్మినల్స్, ద డిఫరెన్స్ బిట్వీన్ ఇన్వర్టింగ్ అండ్ నాన్ ఇన్వర్టింగ్ టెర్మినల్స్ వోల్టేజ్ డిఫరెన్స్ బిట్వీన్ ఇన్వర్టింగ్ అండ్ నాన్ ఇన్వర్టింగ్ టెర్మినల్ వోల్టేజ్ విల్ బి జీరో, బట్ real operational amplifier has an offset value. Okay, next characteristic is last characteristic, important characteristic is common mode rejection ratio, that is CMRR. So దాన్ని మనం CMRR అంటాం. So the common mode rejection ratio refers to the situation when the same voltage is applied to both inverting and non-inverting terminals of an operational amplifier. The common mode rejection refers to the ability of the operational amplifier to reject a common mode signal. So in case inverting and non-inverting voltages, inverting voltage, non-inverting voltage have same values, inverting and non-inverting terminals యొక్క వోల్టేజ్ వాల్యూ సేమ్ ఉన్నట్లయితే సేమ్ అయితే ద ఆపరేషన్ యాంప్లిఫైర్ రిఫర్స్ దిస్ కామన్ మోడ్ రిజెక్షన్ రేషియో. సో ఇఫ్ ద కామన్ మోడ్ రిజెక్షన్ రేషియో రిజెక్షన్ రిఫర్స్ ద ఎబిలిటీ ఆఫ్ ది ఆపరేషన్ యాంప్లిఫైర్ టు రిజెక్ట్ ది కామన్ మోడ్ సిగ్నల్. So generally common mode rejection ratio is defined as the ratio between AD by ACM, where AD is the A means gain, A means gain, again this is A means గెయిన్ ఏ అంటే ఇప్పుడు కూడా ఇక్కడ రాసుకోవాల్సింది మనం గెయిన్ అది వోల్టేజ్ గెయినా కరెంట్ గెయిన్ అనేది చూసుకోండి సో గెయిన్ మీన్స్ అవుట్పుట్ బై ఇన్పుట్ ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ వి అవుట్పుట్ బై వి ఇన్పుట్ ఉంది అంటే వోల్టేజ్ అవుట్పుట్ వోల్టేజ్ బై ఇన్పుట్ వోల్టేజ్ ఉంది కాబట్టి సో దిస్ ఈజ్ వోల్టేజ్ గెయిన్ సో ఇన్ కేస్ ఆఫ్ కరెంట్ తీసుకున్నప్పుడు అవుట్పుట్ కరెంట్ బై ఇన్పుట్ కరెంట్ ఉంటే దీన్ని ఇన్పుట్ సారీ కరెంట్ గెయిన్ అంటారు కరెంట్ గెయిన్ అండ్ వోల్టేజ్ గెయిన్ ఓకే బోత్ ఆర్ రిఫర్డ్ బై ఏ వేర్ ఏడి మీన్స్ డిఫరెన్షియల్ గెయిన్ ఆఫ్ ఆపరేషనల్ యాంప్లిఫైర్ ఇక్కడ ఏడీని ఏమంటాం గెయిన్ డిఫరెన్షియల్ గెయిన్ ఏ డి మీన్స్ దిస్ ఈజ్ డి సారీ దిస్ ఈజ్ డి AD by ACM. So what is then a CM? This is CM means common mode gain. Common mode gain of an operational amplifier. So what is the value of this common mode rejection ratio for an operational amplifier? So this value is infinity again. So that means it is ability to reject all common mode signals. సో ఏం చేస్తుంది అన్ని కామన్ మోడ్ సిగ్నల్స్ని రిజెక్ట్ చేస్తుంది సో ఆల్సో ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ ఫార్ములా సో వీ కెన్ సీ దట్ ఏడి ఈజ్ ఇన్ఫినిటీ ఒకవేళ ఈ వాల్యూ కనుక ఇన్ఫినిట్ ఉంటే ఫర్ అన్ ఐడియల్ ఆపరేషనల్ యాంప్లిఫైర్ ఏసీఎం ఈజ్ జీరో దేర్ ఫోర్ సిఎంఆర్ఆర్ ఆఫ్ అన్ ఐడియల్ ఆపరేషనల్ యాంప్లిఫైర్ ఈజ్ ఇన్ఫినిట్ సో దేర్ విల్ therefore it will reject any signal which is common to both so hence the real operational amplifier have finite CMRR and does not reject all common mode signals so idi ok vali value infinite undi anukunte real operational amplifier has infinite common CMRR and which does not reject all common mode signals so ideal operational amplifier em cheyali ante so common mode signals anni reject cheyali so kaani common mode signals reject cheyali kaani so ikkada manam general ga real amplifier kan teesukunnappudu so finite CMRR unnappudu so it does not reject all common mode signals those are the characteristics of ideal operational amplifier okay so once again I repeat you so first characteristic is what is the characteristics first characteristic of ideal operational amplifier is open loop gain most important question first one is open loop gain so this value is infinite second characteristic is input impedance so this value for a ideal operational amplifier is infinite output impedance so this value is zero for ideal operational amplifier bandwidth so this value is also infinite offset voltage d this value for ideal operation amplifier is 0, and the final one is common mode rejection ratio, that value is infinite. So those are the characteristics of ideal operational amplifier. Okay, so most important question. So all of you should prepare well. Okay, thank you.